We're going to talk about streaming services and audio quality and why 160 kilobytes Vorbis or Opus is superior to damn near anything your MP3s have. Okay, so this is going to be a video trying to dispel some misunderstandings about streaming music and audio formats and quality and stuff. And very often I see people complaining like, oh, well, this website only has music available in 160 kilobits, but I want it in MP3 320 kilobits. And here's the thing. This is very important. You got to understand this. The internet really doesn't use MP3 anymore. In fact, if we go over here to, this is the Spotify Wikipedia page. Now, this information is a little older, but still quite relevant. This is August of 2022. And right now, if you have Spotify Premium, for example, it's up to 320 kilobits of Vorbis or 256 kilobits of AAC. But even with the free version, it's 160 kilobits of Vorbis and 128 AAC. Now, this is actually right here is far superior than what you're expecting with MP3 because Vorbis, AAC, and Vorbis's younger, newer, more powerful cousin, Opus, sounds better at 128 than most MP3s do at 320. And the fact that Spotify Premium offers it at 320 kilobits and 256 kilobits AAC, this means we're talking about an audio quality that would 9 times out of 10 not be recognizable as compressed to people with a blind study test. And they've done blind comparisons. Here we are. This is a blind comparison data of the different formats that Opus does. Opus and Vorbis, that are cousins. As you can see, AAC does a little bit better around 64 than Opus. But once you get to the 128, now you can't really zoom in here, but MP3 at 128, not nearly as good. And this keeps on growing when you zoom in there. The quality of the Opus codec is probably superior, superior to most formats. Opus is hands down the best codec. Vorbis and AAC are both amazing. MP3 is old. How old is MP3? Well, let's look this up here. I'm going to go Wikipedia MP3. The MP3 format was made in 1991. Let that sink in. 1991. How old is Opus? The Opus audio format was made in 2012. A lot of technology and understanding how audio works has changed from 1991 to 2012. It's like a mass amount. So yes, sometimes you will get lower quality audio. I mean, higher quality audio from a lower bitrate using new formats. That brings me to YouTube Music. YouTube gets a lot of crap for being not sounding good, even though they are using Opus. I'm going to show you here. This is one of my songs I made. It's called Warm. I made it in Ardour because I'm a nerd. And I published it. And I'm going to go ahead and we're going to look at the DAC-F here on YTDL. YTDLP is what formats are available. If we look at this, we're going to see here are the different formats. Now, we can ignore all the video formats because that's just going to be a still image. And that doesn't affect the audio quality at all whatsoever. But if you look right here at codec number 251, it's in a WebM container, but it's the Opus audio format in 146. That's loose bitrate, so it's averaging target around 160. And the M4A AAC is going to be around 128. So even on YouTube Music, the Opus audio quality is going to be really, really good. That's why I'm not sure where people are getting the idea that the audio quality on YouTube is not good. I think their player might just diminish a little bit. And I think certain browsers, it's going to be loading the M4A version, which sounds good, but not great, I guess. I think that's probably the biggest failing right there. But do they pass for crystal clear audio? Totally. They sound great. If you use YouTube DLP to grab my track warm and you listen to it like directly as the file itself, it'll sound really good. And I've compared it to my raw PCM master that I uploaded for distribution, and I can't tell the difference. I can go in there and analyze and see the spectrum is not installed because all compressed formats usually cut off that really high spectrum that you and I can't hear because it's outside of the human range hearing. That part's usually diminished a bit. But other than that, you can't tell that it was compressed. I'm constantly given this comparison of the 160 versus 320 in different codecs, and I can't state enough how big of a difference it is as someone who's used to cultivate I still do cultivate a local library of compressed files because I don't know when I'm always going to have internet. I have my entire library of songs on my phone, which is great. I can go like camping where there's no signal and I can listen to everything in my library. And that's really nice. Technically, you could do the same with Spotify or possibly Google Music and maybe even those Apple Music, whatever it is. But it's not quite the same. And also you're kind of limited on how and what you want to play it on. Where actually having raw files on your hard drive, they're always there. They're always going to be there.